I need to hear from Chief Olisa Metu, and I like you, Chief Metu, to quickly go to the point straight, because you have 30 seconds for this conversation. The question is, did you collect money from the former NSC?
I did not. I have never been to the National Security Advisor Office. I did not collect any money from the National Security Advisor Office. But you need to know that this persecution is more than that, Sheun. This is a witch hunt, and it's not a fight against corruption. It's actually a fight against political opponents. And I wanted to explain it to you why it's not. And how do you expect someone to get justice when actually that you are giving a directive to the judiciary that they must convict? How can you call someone a looter when he's in court? How can you say the person stole by force when there is no evidence about it? When you are actually saying that he ought to have known that the money that was paid into his account is an unlawful activity. You haven't proven it. The predicate offense has not been proven. You have not established anything. Maybe because you think you can manipulate the judiciary. You come about and you announce names of people and you give directive and body language and signal to the judiciary. They should not allow such people to get justice. And you think this is a country. This is not the democracy that our leaders, our forefathers, our founding fathers established for and sustained in this country for 15 years. Let me tell you, Shane, is it incontrovertible that PDP is a party that ensured that offered and provided equal opportunities to all Nigerians? We ensured the principles of democracy. We fought for it to be enshrined. We allowed people their fundamental human rights, their liberties. What is happening in this country right now?
Just take a pause. Chief Metu, calm down. Calm down. Take a pause.
We do not overtax people.
Chief Metu, take a pause. If you listen to me, so I can ask you the question and we can get the progression. Thankfully, the management has asked that we extend the program for some more minutes so that we can get clarity on some of this issue. The program is supposed to have ended by now, but it's going to be extended so that we can get clarity. So, Chief Metu, I will ask you some more questions, and I would like you to speak to the questions that I've asked you. The question is the fact that you said you did not collect money from the former NSC. So you pleaded for, you had a plea bargain. So where was the issue of the plea bargain coming from?
Thank you very much, Sharon. I have never engaged in plea bargain. I have never been involved in plea bargain. And there is absolutely nobody in this country, no record to show that I've done plea bargain, and nobody has come up to say I did plea bargain. I have never done plea bargain. What actually happened was that the agents of this government came to me and said, listen, we're only interested in recovering the money. If you can give me, I said, I don't have 400 million naira. My friends and families insist, my family and friends and associates insisted that if that is the problem that they want, if the government is looking for money to go and do the amenities, if they're looking to obtain money from people by any means whatsoever, then let them come and take the money. So they got the lawyers to write to them that they can do it as long as you drop all the charges, provided that you drop all the charges, since he did not commit any crime. Of course, they never answered us. I mean, that's about 2 years, more than a year ago, or 2 years ago. They never answered.
You ran in your capacity as a spokesperson of the PDP at the time. You ran the campaign in your capacity. Where did you get the money from?
Sharon, I did not engage in the campaign of the PDP. I was not involved in the presidential campaign. I did not participate in the presidential campaign. The particular transaction they're talking about happened before the campaign started. And it happened before the president declared that he was going to run as president. And it's actually an assignment, and it's in court. The records are in court. They have witnesses who have given the evidence. I have witnesses who have given my own defense evidence, and it is clear that it had nothing to do with our party. And here you are talking about PDP. I want to ask Sharon, is PDP an individual? People come to the television and they say PDP has looted. PDP has looted. If there are individuals that have looted, please charge them to court. The individuals, even if they've gone to APC, charge them to court. But do not say the PDP has looted, because the PDP is not an individual, and there is nothing that has been established against the PDP. The fight against me is that you think that because you have a former National Police Secretary, you can use him to establish a new case against the PDP, indict PDP, and target PDP before the elections. That is not democracy. That is persecution. And
but
that is-
you're saying that, so let's get this clarity. You are in court because there are allegations that you took money from the former NSA to the tune of about over 1 billion. At some point, it was said that it was 400 million. So you're saying that not a dime did you collect from the former NSA. So what exactly is your relationship with the former NSA around the period of the election that has to do with money? And the company that was linked to you.
I will not have answered you, but since the trial is now public, I will answer you directly. I had no relationship with the former national security advisor. I had a relationship with my president, who was the leader of my party. And sometime in 2014, I made a presentation where the president had called, national chairman took me with the leaders of the party. The Senate president was there, the vice president was there, the national chairman was there, a lot of people were there. And after we did presentation, a lot of people, there were issues to do with some things that the president felt needed to be established before Nigerians can enjoy free, fair elections. And I was asked to lead the campaign of people who were working with the president to ensure that we establish that because of my assets to a lot of people across the country, especially our party members and contacts with people. So I led these eight and people who were close to the president to ensure that we establish completely, we did assignment for the nation. And right from when I was arrested, I had established it from day one. What I did was not a campaign for the PDP. It was before the campaign started. It had nothing to do with the general campaign. The person that was the presidential spokesperson is totally different from Tshifolisa Sametso. And it had nothing to do with the campaign of the president. The campaign of the people who established, were attempting to establish.
I must allow you go now. I must allow you go.